Right now, I'd like to invite Dr. Michelle Spear Lee to the stage. And while she's coming up, I want to share a little bit about Michelle. She was a highly decorated athlete, earning 3 letters in track and volleyball during her career at Oak Ridge. She led the Pioneers to the state track title in 1985 and runner-up finishes in 86 and 87. She concluded her senior year earning All-American honors, along with winning the National Indoor Long Jump Championship. While attending FSU on a track scholarship, Michelle's promising career was cut short by a back injury. Michelle has spent 21 years in healthcare services. For the past 7 years, she served as an acute care nurse practitioner and supervisor of ARNP services for the hospitals group. She earned her doctorate from Chatham University in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and Michelle was inducted into the Oak Ridge Athletic Hall of Fame last year. Please welcome Dr. Michelle. My ninth grade year, graduated from ninth grade.
the tall guy, curly hair, you know it's Jerry Curl. He was nice looking. Same situation. Who was the star before I knew him? Bang. Race starts. Crowd leads to the feet. Spectators are up. The team is on the fence. And what do you hear? Work, we work. Work, we work. Work, we work. It was something to behold. The camaraderie of the team, the way they cheered each other on, the way they challenged each other, the way they encouraged each other, the way they succeeded together. It's summer of ninth grade, and finally, I'm going to be a pioneer. I had watched the Oak Ridge athletic team from the periphery for years, and I had seen this dynasty, and I was ready for my opportunity. Opportunity. Through the Oak Ridge Athletic Program, I was afforded the opportunity to meet incredible mentors through the forms of educators, coaches. I'll wait for my coaches right now. You're up. They had just as much dedication as the student athletes as we did to doing our best. The coaching staff, they invested creativity, ingenuity, into the practice regimen. And I believe this was part of the magic that created the product of the Old British athletic teams. Athletics afforded me an opportunity to travel throughout much of the country, which was very unusual for a young lady from my neighborhood. I got to travel all over. Follow me quickly down memory lane. School's out. It's summer. Coach says, we all got to stay in shape. It's summer league, and we're running track. I think it must have been chicken Olympics. And I am with my compadres, my friends. Getting ready for Junior Olympics. And our 4x4 relay team had qualified Kim Mack, Carolyn Smith, Felicia Chanel, and myself. Off to Hershey, Pennsylvania, we go. And I think we're wearing orange and green uniforms. It was amazing. We performed as expected. We won. They gave us some cool tennis shoes that were brown. But this was part of the experiences that we had, and this was the beginning of wonderful friendships that athletics had afforded me. I had the opportunity to meet wonderful people that would go on to develop lifelong friendships. One of those being Leonard Lee. I met Leonard Lee 33 years ago. I didn't marry Leonard Lee. He is my husband. He is my best friend. We've been married for 29 years, and we created a little daughter. This is part of the legacy that we're going to bring. I've also met many, many amazing athletes, including my husband Leonard, my friend Kim, Michelle, James, Dre, Wanda, Janet, Jabini. I could stand here and list many, many people, but we don't have all night. Tenacity. Now, this quality of being persistent, my definition of stick-to-itness, this is coming to my adulthood. This is what I'm carrying forward to the present day. I learned this from my family. However, I spent so much time in Oak Ridge. I believe that this character was honed on the practice field, on the track, with my coaches and my friends. My coach would break down like every aspect of my jumps. The approach, the plan, takeoff, follow through, the landing. I think about these things as I go through my work. This is my tenacious spirit. And people wonder how do you get things done? Because I think about things in a different way because of things that I've come through. And I think that coach kind of embedded something in me way back when that I kept those characteristics of carrying me through my professional life now. Story time. Orlando Sentinel, Headline, April 24, 1987. Headline reads, Spear hopes one jump will be enough. It's my senior year, and it's District 4 meet. This will qualify the athletes to go to the state meet. I have a back. I had rest in my back for a long time, and I thought I was ready to go. I just needed to take one jump to carry me through to the state meet. Plan was executed. I did my one jump onto the state title. On its way. Unfortunately, and fortunately, this back injury would end my career. During my freshman year at Florida State University, additionally, it postponed my educational goals due to a hospitalization from the back injury. Yet, I believe my tenacious spirit that was cultivated on the track from my family and my coaches through sweat, muscle ache, repetition, precision, practice, preparation, preparing for the world stage and what was yet to come. This is where I get to my work ethic. The principle that hard work is intrinsically virtuous or worthy of a reward. Many of us can probably remember that one workout, the one that you knew was going to work. You're going to pay for it later. Was it the 10 and 0? Was it having to run to the airport? Was it wall sits? Was it running suicides? Was it weight training day? You fill in the blank. No matter what the obstacle, the coaches had a reason behind this regimen. It was going to impact the outcome of the performance. Story time. Many people ask me, do I regret the way that I'm tracked for anything? My answer to them is, I do not. If I did not have the coaches that I had, challenging me the way they did, encouraging me through adversity, through injury, through some disappointment, I would not be the professional that I am today. I'm a hospitalist. I see 15 to 20 patients whose lives have been, for some reason or another, acutely changed. I'm afforded the opportunity to change their lives through medicine, through stories, through genuinely caring for them. When appropriate, I share my story, just a little bit. Maybe that's enough to give them hope, alongside the prescription I'm here right now. The patient needs, and maybe that is just enough to motivate them to get them through their period of right adversity. Legacy. This is defined as something that happens or exists as a result of things that happened in earlier times. So I would like to thank the 1977 men's track team who will be inducted this evening. Because they were the first wave in the ocean of Oak Ridge Track State Championships, both men and women. The Oak Ridge High School athletic program is a distinct part of the legacy. As a pioneer student athlete, I was encouraged to strive to my full potential. I believe such events as this event that we're holding tonight, the Hall of Fame recognition ceremony, are important not only for past athletes, but also for our alma mater, for future and current students athletes. It is useful to exchange ideas, grow our community, see Oak Ridge continue to be the opportunity that we have for the youth that surround us. So Hall of Famers, past and present and future that may be in the room, let's continue to use our talent to support Oak Ridge Pioneer as this legacy that it is, because it was, it is, and it always will be great to be a pioneer.